Saturday, August 9th.
Actually, the 8th.
Just hanging out, watching this Yankee doubleheader. What they're doing with doubleheaders for this shortened season is they're doing 7-inning games instead of 9-inning, which is kind of nice. But they're also true doubleheaders. They're not a 1 o'clock, 7 o'clock. It's like a 1 o'clock, 4 o'clock type deal. So they do them back-to-back, which they can do because it's not like they've got to empty the stadium and bring new ticket holders in. Ran a couple of errands earlier today. Buddy of mine texted me to let me know that this bourbon that is brewed by a family friend's distillery, Old Folk Bourbon, was for sale here locally. And it's not for sale all that often in this area. It's pretty highly sought after. So I ran down and got a couple of bottles of that and then swung by the local distillery, Albany Distilling Company, like I did last Saturday, to grab this. They've got this passport thing. I'll show you a picture of it. But you can go from brewery to brewery, distillery to distillery here in the capital region of New York, get them stamped, and you get prizes. It's just kind of a cool thing to do. I'm certainly not going to be doing that in the middle of the pandemic, but I've gotten the passport itself the past 2 years, so I'm like, it's out there. I want to kind of make sure I got a complete set. So I got that, got a stamp, you know, had a quick drink and watched the Yankee game on my phone, and now I'm home in the man cave watching it, and there's the dog whining in the background, and Yankees are up 5-0, bottom of the fifth. Hopefully they win this game. Hopefully they win tonight, too. Good morning, Sunday, August 10th. Just sitting
it's
on
the
ninth. Back deck.
I'm off by a day still.
Coffee, and just a beautiful, nice day so far. Not too hot. Blue skies. Here, I'll turn around. Let you
beautiful see. Morning here in the hood. This is my coffee. Don't mind the brick. I use that actually for when I smoke ribs on my little hibachi grill there. There's Sammy also enjoying it. Beautiful blue skies. This is my bird feeder that occasionally you see birds flying in and out of, as well as there's one out there. It's a little hard to see, but just a beautiful one.
So I just love the scene, you know, scene with a capital S that forms around the music, live music scene, you know, and a bunch of the bands I see. And it's funny how you get a Venn diagram of like, if you like the whole city, you're probably going to like Fontaine's D.C., and if you like Fontaine's D.C., you're probably going to like another Irish band called Just Mustard. And one of the Bandcamp purchases for Bandcamp Friday I made was some vinyl from Just Mustard. And I'd seen them, God, in November up in Montreal. Anyways, fast forward to this morning, I wake up and I find that somebody had gifted me on Bandcamp a copy of the live recording of a Hold Steady show from Toronto. Ironically, it's a show that I actually attended. It was a great show. And it was from this guy, Ray, this Irish guy that I met in line. He was in line behind me waiting to get into the Fontaine's D.C. show. Oh, there goes a dog chasing a squirrel or a dog out front. But anyway, he just was waiting in line behind me as we were waiting to get in. We got chatting, comparing music and stuff as often I do. And we stayed in touch afterwards and we'll compare music and stuff. It's been a while since I've heard from him. I don't think I, maybe end of last year. But anyway, he'd seen on Bandcamp that I bought Just Mustard. So he's like, you know what, hey, I'm glad you discovered them. We were talking about them. Here's a gift for you. And ended up chatting with him, and he's doing fine and stuff like that. But it's just representative of kind of the music scene out there where you just meet random fans. I've got probably half dozen people that I'm friends with that I just happened to meet because they were standing next to me at a show, and or I always see him at shows and stuff like that. And that's really kind of that just kind of randomness, but people just being open and friendly to making connections that I really enjoy about going to live shows, and just really thoughtful of them. Again, it's you know, I mean, it was probably a $5 purchase or something like that, but it was just nice that out of the blue, he just was like, hey, you know what? I appreciate that you appreciate music. Here's something for you. So caught up with him, and we were both lamenting not being able to catch shows and stuff, but thank God he and his family are healthy and safe, etc., which is all you can work, all you can hope for in these troubling times. But figured I'd share that kind of at least I thought it was a nice way to start the day.
You know, life still has its challenges. Here I am doing laundry, and I realized normally I've got a bunch of hangers hanging there to hang my shirts on, but they're all upstairs, so I'm having to fold it. Yeah. Life's hard in a 2020 pandemic.
In case you were worried, I did persevere and actually hang up the shirts. It was hard, but I did it.
All right, it's Monday, August 10th, and going through one of those updates where it's been like 25 minutes there Now, luckily, it's given me this. Okay, almost there. Okay, it looks like here we finally
are. All right, so I've been intermittently being good about getting on the treadmill and running and walking and stuff. Lately, I've been bad about it, so. But now I got a good run in tonight. Did yesterday as well. Hopefully, I can keep it up.
Tuesday, August 11th. Man, it is hot as hell out and humid. I had a guy servicing my air conditioning today. It was working fine, but I needed to get a pump replaced. Fucking adulting. But just found out I got selected to buy an Amazon Echo Loop, which is their newest product. It's like a ring that you can wear.
And it acts just like an Amazon Echo that you're just wearing as a ring. But a couple things. One, I don't wear rings, really. Two, I'm not out and about enough anymore to warrant it. I mean, I've got my whole house wired with these things, but this just seems over the top, and I don't think I'd use it.
So everybody's been waiting on this, but Biden has chosen Kamala Harris as his running mate, which I think is a solid choice.
Wednesday, August 12th, hump day, making some dinner, waiting for the Yankee game to come on, Yankees Braves. I'm actually sporting my Yankees Frazier shirt. Now, this is an OG Frazier shirt. Clint Frazier was the centerpiece of a trade back in 2017 when the Yankees decided, hey, we're too old. We need to revamp this team. They went through a rebuild, traded this pitcher, Andrew Miller, to the Indians, and Clint Frazier came over, just a stud batter and outfielder. And he started off in the minors. I actually got to see him in Syracuse play. But then he got called up and actually had a really hot freaking summer that year. Just for a brief stint while he was up. What's amazing is I was at the game July 8th. I think it was his debut, actually, with the Yankees. And we were down to Milwaukee, 3-2, going in bottom of the ninth. He's up. He's got two runners on. I think it's one out, and he goes deep. Walk-off home run. Unbelievable. I'm watching it from stands at this point, which is want to do. Typically, I'd head over there the last inning and get my spot.
Good spot for the Yankee rookie, Clint Frazier. The 1-0. Driven to left field and deep. Going back, Perez, turning, looking. See ya! Ball game! A big home run for Frazier! A huge win for the Yankees!
So, place goes nuts. I promptly get my phone out and I custom order this shirt with number 30. Correction, I just checked my Facebook post from that game. I had actually just ordered it, and then he hit the home run, which is an even better fucking story. Comes in like it's Saturday. I think it comes in on Wednesday, and I think the trade deadline was maybe Thursday that week. Might have even been Wednesday. So it comes in on Wednesday, and lo and behold, the Yankees trade to get David Robertson, a pitcher who had been with them before, veteran pitcher, who wears number 30. So he comes in, it's like, hey, Rook, give me my freaking shirt back. I'm sure there was some kind of compensation or something going on, or maybe he just deferred. So Frazier gave up number 30 and went to number 77, which is what he wears now. But I do have a number 77 shirt that says Red Thunder, which is his nickname, on the back. But I still got this Frazier number 30. So probably a hell of a lot more than you ever wanted to know about that. But now you know.
Frazier!
And Frazier's first at bat, he goes to unbelievable. They ended up winning 6-3. Frazier ended up going 3-4. And then even more impressive, LeMahieu went 4-5.
Thursday, August 13th. We're about to find out if almonds go bad. As I'm looking at this, I had them here at my office. And I see it says sell by December 18, 2017. So 2.5 years ago. They taste fine.
Probably would have been smarter to Google this before I ate them.
All right, so how did I end up triggering the algorithm that this popped up on my freaking Twitter feed? What the hell? Jesus.
Just leaving Stewart's. I don't know if there's anything more aggravating or delaying than getting behind that customer that is buying both lottery tickets and cigarettes.
Ordered pizza tonight. Food coma.
Here's the part where I talk about music. So I'm going to share some of the live footage I took from the show that I saw Just Mustard up in Montreal. Funny story about that show, but let me first describe how I found Just Mustard. had discovered Fontaine's DC, and that kind of turned me on to a ton of great music coming out of Ireland. The Murder Capital is another example. Just Mustard's one, Pillow Queen's, a bunch of good artists. And how I found out about it is started digging into Fontaine's DC, and then I also took a trip to Ireland after attending the Yankees-Red Sox game in London and got hooked on a couple of podcasts and a website, like a publication called Niler 9, which follows the music scene over there, as well as started listening to 8 Radio, which is the Dublin indie radio station. Pace Magazine also had an article of, you know, top Irish indie artists to watch for, and that was a good source of information as well. But anyway, I started reading about Just Mustard, checked it out. I'm like, I like these guys. And that's the beauty of Spotify. It's got its ills, obviously. It's really streaming music in general has really upended the music industry over the past 15 years, I guess, now. One of the beautiful things about it is you can just find, as a consumer, you know, you don't have to wait for, you know, the powers that be at the label to push it out to the radio stations and have the program directors decide they want to play it, etc. You can just go directly to the Bandcamp, to Spotify, to YouTube, and just find their music. So that is definitely one of the pros. It has definitely leveled the playing field as far as the music industry. But anyway, so that's how I came across Just Mustard. And I'd been tracking them and a couple other bands, saying, geez, because I'll keep an eye out for these bands and say, hey, if they are either going to come to Albany or New York, Boston, Montreal, kind of the general area here, I'll try and catch them live. And I saw, popped up on Facebook, that they're playing a show in Montreal along with this other Irish artist called Jealous of the Birds. I was like, awesome. I'm like, it was a Friday night. I cashed in points for a hotel room. I've got a buddy that's up there. Turned out he wasn't there. I'm like, screw it. Drive up to Montreal, checked into the hotel, get to the venue where it says it is, and it said it was a free show. I'm like, okay. So I get there, and there's really not a crowd there other than what you'd expect for a Friday night happy hour crowd. I'm like, is there a show tonight? They're like, oh, yeah, it's in the back. I'm like, okay, that's kind of odd. So go back there, and I go through the doors, and there's almost nobody there, maybe 10 people there. Small room, stage set off to the left, bar in front of me, and a guy at a table sitting there. And he's like, hey, how you doing? He's like, who you with? I'm like, what do you mean, who am I with? I'm here to see the show. He's like, yeah, who you with? This is an industry event. Do you have your laminate? I'm like, oh, shit. I'm like, look it, dude, I just drove 3 hours up from Albany just to see this show. And I'm like, you guys posted it on Facebook on your events page as a free show. So I thought it was a free show. And he's like, ah, oh. He's like, don't worry about it. Just because you came up, see the show. So I ended up talking to the guy, the promoter that had set it up, ended up chatting with him throughout the night. It was an interesting conversation, but also got to meet Just Mustard and chatted with them. They were funny because they'd just flown in and they were like, yeah, we were drinking pretty hard at the airport prior to the flight over. But anyway, show was great and their music's great as well. So like I said, I had an interesting conversation with the promoter at this event. It was an industry event. It was basically a conference where a music industry organization in Canada was sponsoring, partnered with, I think it was both Ireland and Korea to showcase these bands. And a lot of people have always said, oh, you're so into music, you spend so much time seeing shows and researching and listening to music that you should get into the business. Now, a couple reasons I haven't is, one, the money. I make good money doing what I'm doing. I enjoy what I'm doing as a supply chain guy, and it actually pays for me going to do all this stuff. Secondly, is I enjoy being a fan. And my concern is, and it kind of has been validated, is that should I get into the business, it would become a job and it would be less enjoyable. And this event, even though I love seeing Just Mustard, kind of confirmed that. Because what was interesting is that the bands would get up, and there was probably 5 bands or so that played. And unlike at a normal show, you know, where there's that feedback from the crowd is really into it, the band gets up and the band will give off energy to the crowd, and then the crowd, the fans, give energy back to the band, and it's kind of this loop of energy that builds and both sides benefit from it. At this event, I compared it was like sitting in a conference room and somebody throwing up a PowerPoint slides. The band just got up. Nobody, there was no like, yay, you know, no response from the crowd because it was all just a bunch of label, you know, music industry types. And they just started playing. And when they got done, there was no applause. It was just kind of like, okay, next presentation, please. It was really weird. So that definitely, if I thought about, geez, I was hesitant to get into the business as before, that confirmed it. So anyway, here is song, or at least excerpts from the song Seven. From Just Mustard. If you want to see the whole thing, I'll put the link to the whole video of that show.
Here.
And the magic is gone.
I get from Amazon.
Another AliExpress watch here, Chinese special. Nothing fancy as far as the packaging, but I didn't pay a lot for this watch either. It's called the Navi Force. Got the days of the week there, going up and down there. It's a stiff feeling, almost a plasticky feel. It's actually one of the first watches I ordered. It was relatively cheap. I'd have to look at what the cost was. Let me check this out and see if it actually comes and it's worth anything. It does have, if you look at the second hand, it's got the Navi Force little logo there on the backside, which is kind of a neat trick to it. I'm assuming those hands are loomed. So pretty much what you'd expect out of a $19 Chinese watch from AliExpress. No loom, the band's kind of crappy, but you know, it's a good beater watch. And it was a good way to take AliExpress for a test run. All right, so I'm in the basement now. So I am now the proud owner of a new condensate pump for my air conditioner.
That is the condensate pump.
And there's the air conditioner, a water heater. As you can see, there's still some water drying up around here. So basically water that was accumulating with the air conditioner with the condensation and stuff like that. It's just spilling out. That's a nice little puddle. Got the fan drying it up now.
Not as exciting as other things you can buy, but you know, you do what you gotta do.
Alright, so this is my third AliExpress Chinese watch. Not sure which this one is. I'll find out momentarily. I've got two, so okay. Basic box just slides out. Alligator skin profile to the cardboard. It's all in there. You got an English. It's all good. And just like a lot of them, they give you kind of, you get one instruction manual that covers all their watches. Warranty card. Cloth. And here is the watch itself. What do we got here? I'll need to slid this down in here to keep it down. Yeah, so I like that pattern there. So it's running, which is got the kind of honeycomb pattern in the background there. Got the Roman numerals around the outside. Got the date complication. Let me see what time it is. It's 11:45. So I can change the date. One clicks. Change it to today. And then just actually, there we go. And the date set. Strap's not bad. Nothing fancy. Logo there. Take the sticker off the back. Open back there. So you can see the rotor. You got the logo there on as well. Here, I'll look up the specs here and go through it. All right. So again, this is Guanquan, which is one of the Chinese makers here. Good looking face. It's got a 40 inch diameter case, 12 inches thick. I assume this comes off. Yeah, there we go. That's what I thought of. Got their logo there on the, I can't really see it that well. Got the G on the crown. Kind of a brushed on the case, and then you got the sapphire dome crystal there. Lugs kind of curve around, as we saw before. You got the open back there. I don't know what the movement is. I assume it's probably a Chinese made one. 20 inch band. Let me see how much I paid for this bad boy. It's $50. So for an automatic watch, that's not bad. Let's see if it, this has still got the covering on it. Okay, I was like, oh shit, is there a scratch on this? But I just gotta get the covering off, so. If I can, there we go. I always like to keep those, so if I sell the watch or something. Yeah, for $50, not a bad looking watch. It's a bit of an odd clasp on this. When I went to put it on, I was like, oh, this isn't just this typical Tang clasp. It's actually got kind of a diver's watch extension here. So let me show you how this works. So you see it kind of articulates there. This actually, if you look here, this actually folds up like that. And then you've got the pin there. This then goes in here. That down, then secures it, then you slide it on the wrist. Let's see how this fits. All right, how the hell do I do this? Got that, and this should fold under. Yeah, I can tell you already, I do not like this, how this thing works. Or does this fold? Yeah, there we go. That folds up under there and then in there. And I got it on upside down. So I don't really care for this clasp. I'll probably end up replacing it with just a regular old freaking buckle. Still a good looking watch. All right, got a couple of posters in the mail here today. Let's open these bad boys up. Move this one off to the side. I'm a big poster collector, usually show posters. These are not show posters. Ah, got a little beat up there on the end as it's coming out and as it was shipping, but that's okay. Yeah, these are the posters from Governor Cuomo talking about the New York Tough poster. Talking about the, he's got a story here for the whole battle with COVID. I'll put a picture up of it, but I thought this would be good to have as a memento. So this is a poster Governor Cuomo had commissioned that's based upon the political posters that they had back in the late 1800s, early 1900s, that visually represents New York's fight against COVID. And the mountain represents the curve of COVID cases going up and then coming down. So I'll share some of the details on the poster. The New York Times actually does a good article of digging in deeper as far as which of the symbolism and different images on the poster, what it represents. But I'll dig into a few of them. You start off with the image of the plane here depicting COVID coming over primarily from Europe and highlighting the confusion that was coming out of the federal government and its response. Then as you go up the curve here, you see the flames representing the outbreak at New Rochelle. The sorry we're closed sign represent New York shutting down in response to COVID and the testing and tracing there. Then as you continue up the curve, you see economy falls as far as the impact on the economy, talking about masks and social distancing as the curve starts to come down. And off to the side, you've got Trump sitting in the moon just saying, oh, it's just the flu. As you come down the curve, one of the things that cracks me up, you see boyfriend Cliff there, which I guess is a reference to one of his daughter's boyfriends. And then you see everybody who's working to pull the curve down there. So it was kind of cool. It was like $12, so we're not talking a lot of money. I'm not going to hang it up anywhere, but like I said, nice memento. Now this one came from the political group, the Lincoln Project. So I describe the Lincoln Project as moderate conservatives who don't agree with Trump and where he's taking the GOP. Again, usually it's show posters. This is not a show poster. So
this will not surprise you if you listen to any of my political rantings. So it's basically just a poster of Trump that just says nope. I need to look at the other one. I can't remember. Yeah, I got the same thing twice. I'm going to send one to my buddy. So, yeah. So a couple more posters out of the collection and really kind of specific 2020 ones at that. All right, now we're back into my more normal deliveries here with some vinyl. Not sure what this is. This could be some of the stuff I got from Bandcamp Friday already. It'd be pretty quick, though. Oops. Yeah, that's what it is. So, Middle Kids. This is not a full-length album. It's really just an EP. But great band. I realized I didn't have it, so I was like, geez, I might as well order this. They're out of Australia, three-piece. Actually saw them play at Albany Distilling Company at a show hosted by WEQ. I got a chance to meet them and talk to them and stuff. They're great. So this just came, and this is actually another one of these. So that had been a end table right there, but I turned it into a bar, so I want to replace it. So that way I've got one on either side of the couple instructions. One page, bag of hardware. This is my kind of construction, just freaking screwing in four things and then four at the top and done.
Friday, August 14th. Hope everybody had a great week. Hope you're enjoying the videos if you're still watching this, if anybody's out there. Just finished reading book 11, Turncoat, of Jim Butcher's Dresden Files. Rereading that series to get so I can read his newest book, book number 16, Peace Talk. So I'm excited about that. I've been listening on Audible, and I'm making my way through a book about every 4 days. So that's pretty good. In the news, you've got Trump doing what Trump does, coming up with some birther conspiracy theories about Kamala Harris, saying that, you know, is she really eligible to be vice president and stuff. Typical racist bullshit. He plays the same card. What's scary is it actually works with a lot of people. Also in the news, a lot of talk about the post office. So there's a Trump crony who has no love for the post office because he's got interests that compete with it, is going through revamping the post office. And Trump basically has come out and admitted that since he's not a supporter of mail-in voting, since he thinks it will work against him, he's defunded in a lot of these changes that are going to the post office, specifically to hinder some of the mail-in votes, which is just fucking frightening. I actually talked to one of my friend's son who grew up in the neighborhood. He's a postman now. I saw him yesterday. He delivered one of the packages I had, and he's like, yeah, it's kind of a mess. So they're even feeling it at the entry-level stuff. So, but hope everybody's well. Thanks for watching. If you're continuing to watch, hopefully the format's a little cleaner. So I'm trying to do Monday through Wednesday or Monday through Thursday, then the music segment, and then do what did Craig get from Amazon, and then finish up with just the Friday segment to close it out.